Good morning, children. Welcome back to the social session of Democracy and Evolving Idea, where we try to learn about Sri Lankan model and Belgian model. In these two countries, what did we really learn these two models? In these two stories of Belgium and Sri Lanka, both are democracies. Both countries, Sri Lanka is a democratic country as well as Belgium is also a democratic country. Yet, even though they were democratic countries, they dealt the question of power sharing differently. The question of power sharing was different. How Belgium has peacefully resolved the issue of minorities question and involved them, included them into the government you have seen, and how Sri Lanka has avoided it and led to a civil strife or civil war in the country you have seen. So in Belgium, the leaders have realized that the unity of the country is possible only by respecting the feelings and interests of different communities and different regions. Such a realization resulted in mutually accepting the arrangements for a sharing power. Even their constitution was also amended 4 times in order to do that. So Sri Lanka shows us a contrasting example, an opposite example, where it shows us that if a majority community wants to force its dominance over others and refuses to share power, it can undermine the unity of the country. How Sri Lanka led into the economical strife because of the civil war also you have seen. So it has undermined the unity of the country and forced the country back several hundred years with internal conflicts and civil wars. So Sri Lanka has suffered because of their stubborn attitude to change or include these Tamilians into the government, and as a result of that, it led to the civil war, and their economical development, their infrastructural development has went back because of their attitude. So this is what the two examples we have learned. If you look at the dignity and the freedom of the citizens in these democratic setups, democracy or democratic governments stands much superior to any form of the government in promoting the dignity of an individual and the freedom of the individual. Every individual wants to receive respect from the fellow beings, whether you belong to high class or lower class, whether you belong to high caste or the lower caste. But an individual will have a self-respect, an individual will have dignity, okay, that has to be given by the fellow beings. Often conflicts arise among individuals because some feel they are offended or they are not treated with the due respect in the society. The passion for respect and freedom are the basis for the democracy, and this passion only made a democratic setup more inclusive and more respect for the minority opinions. Democracies throughout the world have recognized this, at least in principle. They respect the dignity and the freedom of the individual. This has been achieved in various degrees in various democracies. Not every country has its own mechanism or it has its own model where some degrees of respect and dignity is given to the individual. For societies which have been built over ego on the basis of subordination and domination, it is not what we call simple matter to recognize that all individuals are equal. There are some societies in the country which believe that they are superior to others. So in such nations, in such community, okay, recognizing the other individuals, all individuals equally, is not that easy thing, is not that simple. But things are changing today in the modern world. So economy is growing very faster. So people started recognizing the opposites respect as well as the opposites dignity even. So take the case of dignity of women. Most societies across the world were historically male-dominated societies. Women were not given that respect. Even during the French Revolution also, we have discussed about this, isn't it? French women have fought for 2 centuries to get their right to vote. So there are many such cases where male-dominated societies did not give equal status to the women. Long struggles by women have created some sensitivity today, and that respect to and equal treatment for women are necessary ingredients of a democratic society. That does not mean that women are actually always treated with respect. But once the principle is recognized, it becomes easier for women to wage a struggle against what is now unacceptable legally and morally. in a non-democratic setup. If you look at in countries like Afghanistan, when it was ruled by Taliban, so the orthodox fundamentalist Taliban was ruling it. So the rights of the women were completely lost. So this unacceptability would not have the legal basis, because the principle of individual freedom and dignity would not have the legal and moral force there. So once you recognize them in principle, it becomes easier for them to fight legally. The same is true even with the caste system, caste inequalities in our country. Democracy in India has strengthened the claims of the disadvantaged and discriminated caste-based inequalities and atrocities even now are being committed in our country. So against to that, the struggle keeps on going. So we shall also further understand about the dignity and freedom in the next class even. Thank you, children.